campus life in the college, I think, is the best phases of one's life. I entered IIT Kanpur for my master's, that is M.Tech, after having completed my graduation in Government Engineering College, Raipur at that time. And the first impression of once I entered the IIT campus was the sheer simplicity of the whole atmosphere. The genius behind the simplicity, I would say. The slippers and the cycles. So I think that is my first image. So everywhere you would see students from, all students of various branches and various, courses, all on cycle, and typically everybody on slippers attending classes. So I think that was the first impression I had. I carry that impression throughout, that simplicity is the core value of IIT, and with that comes so much more behind which IIT gives us. The atmosphere always encouraging, I would say, because in hostel or in the library where we used to go often, the computer center, you'll find 24 hours it's open, and people of all different grades doing studying in their own times. So it's a very inspiring atmosphere, for anybody who wants to get into it. So I think I vividly remember the images of the library, the computer center, then of course our campus restaurant. I think that was a common point for some good food. And very importantly, the STD booth those days. The students today would not feel it actually, but those times when we didn't have the mobile phones, it was the STD booth there near the lift where we used to all go at night when the rates are less after 10 p.m. and waiting to make calls to our family members. So I think that was another very lively place after midnight, So these were the few images I can share of a very beautiful and memorable campus life. I was into the yoga, which was badminton and swimming. These were the other two activities I was quite regular with. And one was the wall practice of tennis, because as regards badminton, I was also part of the inter-IIT badminton team that year during my master's. And we had been to IIT Delhi for representing IIT Kanpur in the inter-IIT badminton championship. That is another very good memory of these sports activities I had during my IIT days. I did my schooling actually in Bastar, that is Chhattisgarh's tribal area of Bastar. It's a hot Naxal bed now, if you know. And I did my schooling in a school in Jagdalpur. That was the district headquarters at that time. So I think from since then I had this thought, because in a small district headquarters you see the we would always be receiving our as a good student in school, our chief guest would always be the district collector or the DIG or the SP of that place, who will be an IAS or IPS officer, and they would really inspire us, the young students at that point of time, as to how at such a young age one gets to head the district and takes important decisions for that district. So that was something that touched me and inspired me at that point of time. And I did think that I will be very interested to join the civil services. Behind this decision was also the support and the guidance of my parents. Especially my mother, because she really had this dream that I should join the civil services and make a kind of difference. So the focus was very clear. Even when I did my engineering in Raipur and then went for my master's in IIT Kanpur. So I think I had that thought in mind right since my school days, I would say. So it was not a sudden thought, but definitely the atmosphere of IIT and the excellent, the atmosphere and the kind of impact IIT makes on you, price really gives you the impetus to excel in whatever field you are doing. So not only civil services, maybe any field, I think IIT gives you that atmosphere that you can excel. So that is what drove me. I mean, the parents, my parents, and I think whatever I saw during my upbringing in Chhattisgarh and Bastar mainly. The whole atmosphere of IIT takes you at a different level, I would say. The interactions which you have, I mean, any campus is all about the interactions we have with our colleagues, with our mentors, with those who guide us, with our students. So it is an overall an atmosphere which promotes that mutual excellence, which develops those synergies which are required actually to bring out the best in any individual. So that is why we see that year after year, you do find a lot of IITians making it to the top ranks in the civil services exams in India. And for any other exam, I mean, it may be CAT or it may be GMAT or whatever. I mean, the positive synergy which IIT helps you build up is something that is unbeatable. I mean, you don't find it anywhere else, I think. And that really helps to bring out the best in us. So, as you would imagine, I mean, from the serene atmosphere of IIT, one lands into the toughest job of policing. So you can understand that from the serenity, you enter into the chaos of the outside world. My mother tongue was Hindi, and I had landed in Tamil Nadu, where you have to, you can't, I mean, function without knowing Tamil. And that is very valid, because you interact with people at grassroots level. You have to address their problems. And knowing the mother tongue, I realized, was one of the most important step of settling down and being able to deliver what you are made to do. So knowing their language is the first part. The challenge of facing the crowd, challenge of facing the people in pain and misery approaching you, challenge of facing violent situations, deaths, I mean, real crowded situations where it appears that things would really go out of control. So you are physically there, present, handling the toughest moments of one's life. And at the same time, a lot of learning came through about, you know, real life situations, how real life is. One really gets to learn a lot in policing. You visit so many scenes of crime. You take witnesses, you inquire people who have suffered, you inquire others who are part of it. I mean, it is a world unraveling in itself. Women are few in numbers across the spectrum, I would say. So more and more women visible will inspire many more women behind. I think that is how I would like to put it. So women should be visible in across the ranks, across the positions, in every sector, I would say. And every woman there will inspire many more behind. However, women at the decision-making level, I mean, you said it's powerful, but I would say women at the decision-making level in any organization, in any sector, I think that is where we need a higher presence, though it will take much more time for that to happen. But every woman there has a deep influence, has an impact on many women down the line, because she is there at the decision-making level. So more women will inspire more success stories, more role models, and this in turn will inspire many more girls to choose the career of their path. And I think times today are very positive because families do support the girl, do help her make her career the priority, which was not the case in earlier times. A girl's career will not be the priority. But today, I think the times are changing and parents in general do support the girl to choose a career of her choice, to help her grow in that and, you know, maybe make her career a priority of her life. So this is a major shift. And this is where we can have many more girls coming in, because every girl needs a role model. And the more role models you have, the more success stories you have, there'll be many more girls joining behind. Adding to this, you know, about 50% of the population is women. However, we see that in police, the women ratio is really poor. We have really very few women out there in policing. Maybe because of the challenges that's involved, or the women really are not keen to join police at various ranks, right from the constable to the top. Even if one woman from a village joins the police and the day she goes back to her village in her uniform, that has an impact. That has an impact on so many other girls who are looking at her, that, okay, today she is in a uniformed force. Today she is a police woman. That brings so much of, you know, a sense of security, a sense of power, a sense of self-independence and self-reliance, and to be respected. So see, I would say that during our times, in fact, this question used to be asked as an engineer, why do you want to join the civil services? I think today with the changed world, as I said, in the last few years, the world has changed. And the life of a common man has changed because of technology, because of the phone in his hand and because of the internet. So now this, now it is really a technocrat's world. And in fact, governance can be really benefited with more technocrats coming in, I would say. There are a lot of solutions that that the technocrats can provide, and for the benefit of people, as I said. So it is a more tech-oriented world, and I feel the younger generation, as you asked, how can they be inspired, they be motivated to join the government or the governance of today? Definitely, if they are looking even for technology in the job, I think that is there. And if they like the technology part of it, they can definitely contribute immensely to the systems of governance we have today, and they can make an impact. To stick to our core values, whatever, everybody is born with certain inherent strengths, and one should stick to those inherent strength in the times of difficulty. And for example, I would quote one of the lines from Amrita Pritam here. Zindagi tumhare usi gun ka imtihan leti hai jo tumhare andar hai. So as I said, every body is born with some inherent qualities, and that should or inherent strength, and that is what should come to, that is what should be relied upon at the time of crisis or difficulty. And ups and downs are a part of journey. Ups and downs are a part of any examination, any career. It'll keep happening. More important is you stick to your core and you grow from that. I think with those strengths, because you are an independent personality, your journey is different than many others. And it is not correct to compare you with others and get depressed or get demoralized that the other person is doing very well and how come I am not doing very well. So as I said, you have certain inherent strengths in you, and we should focus on that at the time of difficulty. I think that is how we navigate through the ups and downs.